Good evening, everybody. It's an original six matchup from Boston as the Bruins kick off a seven-game homestand tonight against the Canadiens, who finally return to action and have some regulars back in their lineup as they embark on a seven-game road trip. It's Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey here on Sportsnet. Starting goaltenders for tonight's game, Jake Allen back in the pipes for Montreal. He has one win in his past 10 starts in his last seven straight, but he's got a 4-3 career record against the Bruins. He'll look to improve on that tonight. Meanwhile, Linus Ullmark is 6-1 in his last seven starts and 8-2 in his past 10, where he has not allowed more than three goals in any of those games. And right beside him is the backup tonight, Tuukka Rask, who signed a one-year deal with the Bruins yesterday, and Boston's all-time wins leader in goal returns to the team, and they are excited about that.
And frankly, I don't know what to expect from the Montreal Canadiens. They haven't played since January 1st. They have still a depleted lineup, although much better. And we'll see how this starts for them. Somehow they got to get out of the gate against a very red-hot Boston Bruin team.
It's the Bruins and Canadiens. You never know what to expect, and it always is fun one way or another. And we're glad you could join us for this one tonight as Smith is after the puck early for Boston. Mike Hoffman will chip it out, and here comes Arturi Lehkonen with it. Got it across for Nick Suzuki. Throws it on net, blockered away by Ullmark, and he'll cover it up for the first shot of the game.
Well, a pretty good start right there, and Ducharme's had this team practiced at this lineup for at least maybe two practices, and he's still missing so many important players. You got, you know, Edmondson out, Anderson out, Toffoli out, Perreault out, Evans out, Romanoff and Gallagher on the trip, but not playing in this particular game as they're not game ready yet either. So it's
and that's still a big improvement.
It's still a juggling act for the coach.
You consider how many were out over the last couple of weeks with COVID protocol. It's a big improvement.
And let's not forget Carey Price, of course.
But
I mean, he may end up joining the team on the trip. We'll see. There's some rumor of that.
And return to a little more practice time. Curtis Lazard trying to play it. Yoel Armia will get it off the boards and out at center as Brandon Carlo will knock it ahead. Mosik lost it. Here's Jonathan Drouin. That's it around behind the net. Kulak will back off. That allows Carlo to take it up to his own line and now flip it up ahead, and it's tipped into the Canadian zone where Jeff Petrie will get it back. One pass on the wing. Caulfield deflects it in. Ullmark out of the net. He'll move it up around the boards, and it's picked up by Taylor Hall, who's on a six-game point streak with 8 points in the last six games. He's benefited from a line change with David Pastrnak and Craig Smith switching spots. Hall with Hall and Pastrnak, and it's all about speed. Here's Vedemo with it, though. Lucas Vedemo circles around, throws it to the point. Savard trying to find some space. Caulfield will take it and regroup at center.
Interesting, an early giveaway by Boston in their own zone. That surfaced against the Washington Capitals in their last game where they were down 2-0 early and then stormed back.
Ben Sherratt takes it along the boards, throws it in front, and it was tipped by Vedemo and cleared out by the Bruins as Hall will get it to center, and Sherratt is there to take it. Played for Paquette. He'll have to chase after it. He catches up to it. Paquette being watched by John Moore. Dropped it back, and it's flipped up by Charlie Coyle to clear it up. Jake DeBrusk out there for the Bruins trying to get it back as he returns to the lineup after missing four games in protocol. Ullmark hands it off. Turned over again, but Boston gets it back, and Mike Riley, spent three seasons with the Canadiens, will hand it across. It's out at center off the leg of Suzuki, and Montreal resets in their own zone. Chris Weidman got it across, and from center, Nick Suzuki will rattle it in around the glass. Lehkonen trying to play it. Patrice Bergeron comes up with it. Bergeron with speed through center. Played it off of the wing for Smith. Back for Bergeron. Pumped by Kulak. Picked up by Brad Marchand. He'll throw it across to the line. Grizzly gets it on goal, and it ends up in the glove of Jake Allen.
Well, John, you mentioned the Boston Bruin line changes, and give Bruce Cassidy credit, the coach. He went right to the big boys right after the Christmas break and said, look, we want to switch you up a little bit and switch the big line around, just do a little tinkering with it, and boy, has it been successful, as both lines this past six games have been hot. The Bergeron line, 16 points combined, 8 goals, and the Hala line, 19 points the last six games, 9 goals, and they've been getting a ton of offensive production from out throughout the entire group.
Marchand off the draw, and that one gets deflected out of play.
And for the Montreal Canadiens, you have to be encouraged with this start. They've had some zone time offensively. They've been okay. They've been able to keep pace early on here against the Boston Bruins. We'll see how that makes out as they continue throughout the game and how their game conditioning is.
Patrice Bergeron, NHL leader in face-off win percentage at over 64%, and he wins that one away from Dvorak. And here's a little room for Charlie McAvoy with a shot right on, and Allen has got it.
And this is problematic for the Montreal Canadiens, and it isn't every team. I mean, how do you stop Bergeron at the dot? And how do you stop him from creating an offensive chance right from a faceoff? And the Bruins have done this 1,000 times, that set play back to McAvoy, who can really fire the puck after a faceoff win by the NHL's best.
Get him thrown out. And Dvorak wins it away from Craig Smith. Savard got it to center. Boston back on it, though, and it's swung into the Canadiens' end as Allen will stop it. Plays it out for Savard, up for Dvorak. Drouin trying to catch the cross-ice pass from Armia. Now Sherratt will back up with it. Hands it off for Savard, right back for Sherratt. Weak pass for Savard, and that's where you see a little bit of the rust as Hull was in it before Checkenfeld. Sherratt to center. He'll ring it in. Stop packing it by Omar. He'll flip it up around the boards. At the line, kept in by Sammy Niku. Caulfield across for Weidman. Here's Weidman throwing it towards the net. It's blocked, and Omar will make the save.
It's game time. Order all your favorites with Skip the Dishes. Let's get hungry.
Well, the Canadiens in their shoot-ins have been handing it right to the goalie, Ullmark, who's pretty good with the puck. So Montreal's got to start putting the puck in different areas away from the goaltenders. The goaltender's been breaking Boston out of the zone here a few times early on in this period.
Lazar flips it up ahead and knows it couldn't. Point the puck down as Dauphin will play it to the corner. Ryan Poehling goes after it. He's all tangled up with Vekanainen. And out comes loose again. Pass for Poehling. Throws it back around behind the net. Anton Gleedle chase after it. Kept in by Dauphin. Snapped towards the net and it goes wide. Sammy Niku goes after it. He's bumped along the boards. Being watched by Lazar. He'll get a little help here as Nosek comes up with the puck. Nosek also returning from Provokol as he flips it in. Lazar goes after it. Ooh, that's an awkward collision in the boards. And the puck gets cleared back down the ice and will be an icing call against Montreal.
Well, Tuukka Rask coming off hip surgery. Of course, it's been well documented. And the word around Boston is they're pretty pleased with the fact he took a $1 million a year contract. He's going to work out to about $545,000. An underpriced player for his pedigree for the rest of the season, but he thinks his team can win it. He's been a Boston Bruin his whole life, and clearly when teams kick tires with him in the summer, he told everybody he didn't want to play anywhere else but in Boston.
Here's Cole Caulfield flipping it in. Omar hands it off for Carlo, takes the check as he worked it up on the wing, and it's back to the Canadiens line. Jeff Petrie is on it, being watched by Eric Holla. Turned over. David Pastrnak couldn't bring it in. He got stopped at the line. Petrie on it once more. Round for Kulak. Petrie. A little bank pass. It'll end up on the Bruins' end as Carlo goes after it. Hoffman tracking him down. And it gets cleared to center as Kulak is back on it. Lift it up ahead. Mike Riley. played it quickly as handed off for McAvoy. Back to Riley. Trying to weave through center and find a little space. He does. He'll hand it off. Down the wing comes Charlie Coyle. And then he's taken to the boards by Kulak. McAvoy in on the puck. Flipped it around for Coyle. Charlie Coyle sends it to the line. Grizzlick, little shimmy and shake around Suzuki. Played it off for the pass back in the slot. Got away for a moment. It'll come to center. McAvoy put it off the leg of Suzuki, and it'll end up back to the Boston zone. Grizzlick on it, coming off his 5-point game in Washington. As it snapped on net, and Jake Allen has got it in his glove. Well, a good start to this game for the Bruins and the Canadiens as they collide once more this rivalry on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey. Caps.
Well, when you have a player like Brad Marchand and he gets cut wide open here as the Boston Bruins trying to come back in the game, the next shift after getting cut wide open like that, what does he do? He gets a goal and an assist, and you just can't get those kind of leaders. And he's one of the reasons why this Boston Bruin team has been so successful. A lot of people, you know, criticize him if you're not a Bruins fan, but you got to admire his grit and determination, game in and game out.
It's going to be an icing call against Boston here.
And he kind of reminds me a little bit, and I'm dating myself big time, and excuse me for that, but of Brian Sutter. You know, he was a teammate of mine, and it's contagious when you have players that play with that kind of determination and grit and show up every night. And it just goes right through your entire group, and I know it does that with the Boston Bruins, with this guy, the way he plays every game.
Bergeron won the draw again away from Dvorak. Cleared out at center. Sherratt is there. He'll play it off for Savard. Up onto the wing and helped into the Boston end. Or was it? No, they're going to bring it back.
And, you know, you often wonder, yeah, he's a chirper, tries to get the opposition under his skin. And we had a little incident here where he was very successful with Panarin on that particular play. And a pretty good chirp, too, by Pat Maroon on Brad Marchand, who I know delivers his own pretty well also from being between the benches and getting a few giggles once in a while listening to it. He's pretty good at it.
Durant pokes it out at center. Grizzly goes after it, and he'll play it right back.
The game within the game.
Oh, absolutely. There's Marchand backing up. Grizzly has a look, put it into the skates of McAvoy, and now Durant goes right after Charlie McAvoy. Had a pin to the boards, didn't see where the puck was, though. It was behind him as Grizzly comes up with it. Craig Smith trying to play. Sherratt in there to dig it out. Nick Suzuki lets it go as Savard came in for the point. Suzuki trying to play it in front. Smith has got it up onto the wing. And here comes Marchand. Feeds it across. Craig Smith couldn't settle the bouncing puck down. Lekkinen will knock it in as Earl Lekkinen gets in a little bit of trouble there. John Moore played it up for Pasternak. And it's sent right back to the Bruins end, and Moore is on it once more. John Moore hands it off for Taylor Hall. Lekkinen trying to get away from Ryan Palin. Now they go up the middle, and it's blocked at the Canadiens' blue line. Haling trying to find it. He's got it. Hands it off for Caulfield. Weidman will join in. Throws it on net. Kicked out by Hallmark as Haling's there. Back of the goal for Caulfield. Tied up along the boards. Dauphin trying to come over and help out. Eric Holland there as well. Dauphin for Caulfield. Turning away. Swings it back to the near side. Sammy Niku will hold the zone. Dauphin played it back for Pezzetta. Tried a drop pass, cut off by Hall, and he'll leave it for David Pasternak. Long range shot by Pasternak, handled by Allen, and he'll play it off. There's Paquette lifting it to the corner. Trying to get around Brandon Carlo. Comes up onto the wing. As Anton Bleed can't clear it, Vedemo was right on him. Riley will find it. Hezeta goes after Riley with a check. And now Bleed down the wing. Trying to get around Kulak. Takes Petrie into the boards, knocked his helmet off, and Petrie is slow to get up. Here comes Lazar. Petrie's going to get a penalty. He did not put the helmet back on, and then he joined in on the play. And that is a no-no.
Yeah, not a smart play by him. He has to get off. I mean, I don't know why he's even chirping. That's an easy one for the official to call. And before that, a tough pinch here by Savard. And that leads to Hoffman being the defenseman back. He jumps in. Whoops. And then away they go, the Bruins, on the two-on-one. And just Smith failed to click on a real nice saucer pass. Here's Bleed with some pretty good heavy work here. There's the first hit. Petrie doesn't like it. He thinks it's a penalty. And that's why he's doing all the chirping. And then he doesn't get off the ice. And then another giveaway. Bleed with another hit. And Montreal gains possession. Boston now on the power play.
And this power play is brought to you by Kit Kat Chunky, made for hunger. Boston power play, ninth in the league, as Sherratt will hand it off, rolled around the boards. Bruins keep it in. Throw it in front. Bergeron trying to tip it to the goal. Now he'll chop it around for Marchand. Back to the line. McAvoy hands it off. One-time shot. And that one ends up out of play as Pasternak was all set up on the tee.
You know, you finally beat Bergeron on the drop. So this puck has to be out if you're a penalty killer. This is one of the reasons why Montreal's had such a tough time on the penalty kill. Sherratt has it. A soft play. There's nobody on the boards for him. But if not, Sherratt's just going to drill that puck around and get it out. And now they don't. Creates a chance to score for Boston.
Sherratt.
Like that.
Like
that's better.
Gets it off the boards.
And win the draw. And now you get it down. And now you're killing valuable time.
There's McAvoy with it. Up for Pasternak. Through center to Bergeron. Down to Pasternak along the boards. Flipped it to the line. McAvoy has got it. Now they'll set things up. Here's a shot by Marchand over the net. Pasternak. For Marchand. Has a look around. Throws it through the crease. Taylor Hall in front trying to get his stick on it. Bergeron to the line. Pasternak with a shot. It's blocked by Paquette and the puck will come out. Bergeron will lift it back in. Pasternak goes after it. Taken away by Vedemo. And he'll send it down the ice. Stays on it, forcing Boston to move it. Marchand back the other way. Off for Pasternak. Waiting over the line. Vedemo was there, and he'll clear it back down the ice. Allmark leaves it. Grizzlick takes off with it. Here comes Grizzlick up through center. Good move, and his shot goes wide. It skips off the backboards, and Allen will cover it up.
Well, the Bruins will get you a couple of ways. They got a pretty good shooter on the point in McAvoy and Grizzlick, but then they'll go low. And here's their low play, and you can see Marchand trying to shoot the pass for the stick in the front of the net. It almost works, and then, ooh, Allen has to be very careful. The lively boards in Boston.
Savard off for Sherratt, got it off the glass, kept in by DeBrusk. Now it's Coyle to the line for Grizzly. Back to Coyle, being watched by Lehkonen. Down to the side of the net, it bounces around. As Smith couldn't settle it. Grizzly feeds it across, here's DeBrusk. Back for Grizzly, holds, played it off, and a one time by Smith is blocked. Canadians clear it, and the power play is over. No shots for Boston on that man advantage. Puck lifted into the corner. Pezzetta goes after it. Dodge the checker, or Nikku, I should say. Excuse me. Sammy Nikku trying to find it. Can't do it. Carlo with a shot on the short side. Allen knocked that one down. Now it's Ryan Poehling that's got it. Up to center, and he'll roll it in. Poehling couldn't get the puck around Bleed, and it is cleared off the boards and out. Jake Allen tried to stop that one off the glass. Weidman cuts off, throws it. Nikku rolled it up, turned it over. Here's Marchand with it around the goal. Hangs on with a backhand. It's off the outside of the net. Marchand sticks with it. knocked down by Armia. Try to throw it to the point. He caught it there for Carlo. Rolling puck sent across for Mike Riley. Riley waits. His shot missed. Now Poehling trying to get to it. Bergeron with it. Marchand knocked down. And he's slow to get to his feet. Hoffman's on the puck. He'll loop his own goal.
And he shook it up a bit there on that play. Keep an eye on that.
Nikku feeds it up ahead, and it's Caulfield over to Hoffman down the wing. Hoffman throws it in front. Nobody there in a white sweater to get it. Taylor Hall back the other way. Bruins on the attack. 3-on-2. Pastrnak going to the net. Couldn't get the pass from Holla. Eric Holla. No, to Pastrnak. High shot. And a nearly grazed Hoffman in front of the net. Shots even at 5 apiece. Brad Marchand with an opportunity, but denied as he put it off the outside of the goal. At one at Sportsnet now.
Well, I mentioned before the break, Marchand was, seemed like he got a little bit hurt on this play here. Yeah, well, that's why. A pretty good cross check. No penalty on the call, and he went off a little bit sore, worse for wear, chirping a little bit, but is seems to be okay on the bench.
There's Kulak handing it off for Jeff Petrie. Petrie out to center. Picked up by Dvorak. They'll drop it back for Petrie. Sent to the line. Drouin with a shot. It was blocked in front by Charlie Coyle, and he kicks it up ahead as the Bruins move it forward. Oscar Steen tried to settle it down, but it's Armia that had his pass go off the leg. Indians are struggling to get it out of their zone. DeBrusk will hand it off, and it's poked forward by Lazar as Petrie is back on it. And this time it's out as Riley will take it back inside his own end. Mike Riley off the boards and in. And that'll be brought back to the Bruins' end.
Providing competitive odds on all sports, Sports Interaction is Canada's sports book.
Get easier for the Montreal Canadiens either. Their next 7 games are on the road. Of course, not wanting to play in front of no fans in Montreal, so they're going to take off for a while.
Here's Suzuki for Hoffman. Lost a handle. Back for Nikku with a shot. Kicked out by Omar. Nikku pokes it to the corner. Lekkonen rolled it back around. Hoffman on it. Plays it down the wing. Here's Suzuki. Swung it around. Nikku goes after it. Back for Lekkonen, throws it in front, and it ends up right onto the stick of the Bruins, and it's cleared out as Lazar has got it. Curtis Lazar with a shot off the outside of the net. Puck comes back to the point. Brislik going after it. Oscar Steen trying to find space right in front. No shot, scores! Make it a 4-game goal streak for Brad Marchand. He's got the opener in Boston.
I guess he's fine. This is all about Steen. The Bruins really love this young player since he's come up from the American Hockey League. Why? Because they like the way he plays in those tough areas, and he does that to gain puck possession. And then Marchand is coming right off the bench, so he's going to hide from all the defensive players of the Montreal Canadiens. He's cocked, ready to go. He beats his man to the net, and he gets a gift and a beautiful pass from Steen. Tape to tape, no chance for Allen unless he could get his stick into the play onto the pass, which he might have been able to do here and doesn't, and it's 1-0 Boston.
Brad Marchand, 17th of the season.
You don't like to see pucks go right through the crease like that as a goaltender. I mean, he probably didn't know Marchand was over there either as he snuck in, but you've got to get that puck with your stick as it comes across the crease, particularly on that side.
You talk about Oscar Steen. Another attempt here by Smith goes over the net, scores! Marchand again! Seconds apart, it's 2-0 Boston.
We talked about him early.
And here's the first play here. It goes up high on the glass, and Allen never sees it at all. And a weird bounce. Patrice Bergeron sees it, and so does Marchand, and he makes no mistake, as Allen has no clue where this puck is, and nor do any of the Montreal Canadiens after him. Takes an awkward bounce off the glass right into the slot. And when things are going well for Boston, they're going well, and they've been lighting it up offensively the last number of games.
Well, they adjust the time and make it officially 15 seconds apart. And just like that, it's 2-0 Boston on a pair of goals by Brad Marchand. Here's Poehling. Got it back to the point. Throwing towards the net. It's blocked in front. Steen goes after it. Saying about Oscar Steen, he's been on a tear, and he's taken advantage of the Foligno injury to stay in the lineup and made the best of it. He has 6 points now in 9 games he's played in with Boston this year. Here's Coyle. Up to center. Charlie Coyle lost a handle on it. A demo will try to work it back in, and is stopped, and Kulak will lift it in. And now here come the Bruins again. Steen trying to fish it across, and it's broken up. Lazar will flip it in. Miku after it. He's bumped in the corner by Bleed, and the puck comes free. Armia tipped it back. Dvorak over the line as Armia just blew an edge. Now he's back to his feet, but kick of the pass went off the leg of Anton Bleed, who fires it around the boards. Hit it upright in the glass. Convenient bounce. Tomas Nosek has got it. Dropped it for Bleed. Left it. McAvoy trying to go to the net, and that got stopped. Now it is Pasternak into the corner. Wyman up the wing and out. And now it's brought in. Here's Hall. The Pasternak waiting. Allen the save and the rebound. Kick back over on the wing where Armia will lift it out. Here's Carlo. Got it up ahead. Brought back in by Urakala. Left it for Taylor Hall. Lucking it to Petrie. Face of the game is picked up a bit here. Petrie will dump it in, but it's over the glass into the netting and out of play. Well, Brad Marchand gets things going for the Bruins in this one against the Canadiens. 2 goals in 15 seconds, and it's 2-0 Boston on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey on Sportsman. Canadian Sam Montembeau has come into this game as Jake Allen spoke to Graham Rheinbend, the athletic therapist for the Canadians, and then after a few words seemed to say, you know what, something's not right, and I'm gonna leave the game.
I think this happened in warm-up. I watched him in warm-up, and I thought he pulled something in the warm-up, and you know, that's an activity. You don't play for a long time, and I'm, you know, again, I don't want to play doctor here from this far away, but you almost think that perhaps he pulled something there, and that's it for him.
And now Marchand with a chance for the first shot on Montembeau, but he's roughed up by Petrie and taken to the boards.
When does it end for Montreal? I mean, my goodness.
Suzuki will get it out at center, and Bergeron will dump it back in. Petrie knocked it around the wing. Bergeron to the side of the net. Marchand got it back to the line. Here's McAvoy for Bergeron, thrown on goal and steered aside by Montembeau. Nick Suzuki will get it to center, and he'll dump it in.
And you know, John, we talk about the forwards a lot and inactivity over this time, but we should have maybe focused on the goalies a little bit more. It's really difficult. I've been there when you haven't played for a very long time, let alone skated, and jump into a National Hockey League game.
Chance in front, and it's rolled wide by Jake DeBrusk. Played back to the net for Coyle. Now it's Steen on it. Hands it off for Coyle. Broken up, and Laurent Dauphin will come the other way. Dropped it. Poehling walks in. Pass across into the skates of Sherrod. He was set up for the one-timer. Poehling for Dauphin. Waiting. Kicked it up to his stick. Throws it back in front, and Caulfield couldn't get to it. Now Caulfield trying to knock it away. Ryan Poehling back for Dauphin. And Laurent Dauphin couldn't get the shot. Jake DeBrusque will take off with it. DeBrusque down the wing, trying to get around Chiarot. Up down on the boards by Savard. Curtis Lazar after it. Throws it back, and a drive by Grizzlick. Stopped by Montembeau. Rebound in front, and Montembeau got a piece of that. McAvoy with it. Final minute here in the opening period as Grizzlick will play it across. DeBrusque with a shot, scores. It went off Lazar in front. Montembeau arguing, trying to plead his case. And we'll see if the Canadians want to have a look at this one.
And Montembeau with a couple of huge saves before this. And now a harmless looking play. And Lazar in the crease. Might have made contact here as he can't get his pad. Montembeau out in time now. Is he pushed in though, however, from Dvorak? And it'll be interesting to see if the Canadians challenge this at all. So far, no. And I don't think they will.
So Curtis Lazar with his fourth of the season. And now looking for more. Here comes Nosek, and it's right on as Montembeau makes the stop.
And that's like shot, what, four or five already? Montembeau since he's been in. And you couldn't fault him on the goal. I mean, he couldn't even move his right pad because of the traffic in the crease on him. And he complained, asked the ref about it a little bit. And the answer probably was Dvorak was pushing the man into the crease.
As Lazar will push it forward. Miku got it off the glass. Where did it go? No idea.
Let's go back to the second goal of the game here just to show you the play behind the net by Allen. It's a shoot-in. Now, he talks to Savard after this because he wants Savard to peel off for him. Savard doesn't on the other side, so the only thing Allen can do is short around the boards. There's nobody there, and then you get a horrible break as it bounces funny off the glass, and it gets knocked out of the air, and then that's it for Allen, and you can see he's favoring something there after that goal also, getting up very slowly, and that was it for Jake Allen.
Miku will play it back. And now it's Dvorak with it. Here comes Dvorak down the wing. Lazar will settle it down, and he clears it out at center. Weidman jumps up on the play. He'll lift it back in, and that'll be an offside.
Boston rolling four lines now over their bench, and they're getting some added production, added zone time by their fourth line the last couple of shifts. And this Boston Bruin team, as I mentioned, they're running on all cylinders, and Montreal have not playing since January 1 and came out very well, I thought, but that's a tough assignment here, and they're down 2-0 early.
And then things escalated
3-0, pardon me. This one.
Marchand with a pair, Lazar the other marker. Allen's left the game hurt. Shots 12-6 in favor of the Bruins in the first. They're up 3-0 through 20 minutes of play. Carolyn Cameron, Anthony Stewart, and Justin Bourne coming up in our intermission.
I got here, and you can see the grimace on his face. We'll show it to you one more time. And yeah, there's certainly something bothering him there. And we think it's the groin after we saw the way he went over to the bench. And here's the second goal. And again, he gets up very slowly. Not right. You can see him favoring that right groin. Tries it in the commercial break and says, nope, can't do it. I'm done.
So Sam Montembeau came in to take over. He's allowed one goal, and Brad Marchand has two of the three for Boston tonight, scoring twice in a span of 15 seconds, which marked the fastest two goals by a Bruins player since November 18, 2010, when Milan Lucic had two goals, also 15 seconds apart. And here we go with period number two. Dvorak and Bergeron to take the draw. Boston 13-0 this season when leading after the first period. Canadians 1-12-2 when trailing after 20 as Bergeron goes to the net. Couldn't get the puck on his stick though. Yoel Armia will come back the other way. He lifts it in the corner. Grizzlick going after it. Armia reaching into the stick, flipped around by McAvoy up onto the wing. And Marchand will lead the rush over the line, dropped it off. Grizzlick with a shot, and it's deflected out of play.
Well, I can tell you, I've played on more than a few teams that have had difficult seasons, and the talk in the room, most likely within the group of players, was this. Look, let's try and win the second period. Period. We win the second period, we got ourselves back in the game, and we could stop the bleeding that way. And I'm quite sure that was the kind of conversation that went into the thought process between periods. You know, the coach wasn't going to get after them. I mean, that's not going to do any good at this point. It would just make it worse.
Hoffman trying to get a piece of it at center as Riley's there. He'll feed it back up onto the wing. Hall tipped it in. Poster not going after it. Rolled off Kulak. Eric Halla taken to the boards by Kulak. Suzuki trying to dig it free from the pile. Now Petrie up with it as Pasternak was chasing him. Hall back for Pasternak, off his stick and all the way back to the Bruins end.
You know, and sometimes a veteran will stand up and lose it and scream and yell, but I don't think this is the right opportunity for any veteran to do that for the Montreal Canadiens after the situation they've been in of late. They need as much confidence in the room as they can gain here somehow and get something out of this next period.
Charlie Coyle trying to play it, lost a handle on it. Cole Caulfield up onto the wing for Ryan Poehling as he'll go after him in the corner. Taken out on the play by John Moore. Now it is Weidman. Fed back, Poehling is there, takes a shot, goes off a leg, comes free. Ryan Poehling shoots, and that one blocked by Omar, thrown in front by Dauphin. And Weidman will have to track back to get it. Nikou ahead for Dauphin. Dauphin drops it off for Caulfield. Swung it back for Nikou, jumped over his stick, and he's got to go back down the ice to get it. Sammy Nikou being watched by Bleed as he'll play it onto the wing. Savard, he'll hand it off, and that gets no further than the Bruins blue line. Here's Riley. Brought in. Petrie will stop it. Jeff Petrie trying to pull back Bleed as Petrie gets checked. Nosek was right in there as well. Pezzetta hooks it up the boards. Can't get it out. Bruins hammer it back in. Carlo trying to hold the zone. And that one ends up into the Boston bench.
No better start again for the Montreal Canadiens. They came out actually in the first period were okay until the floodgates opened midway through the first. And here's their first good chance of the period here as they throw it down low. Another play off the boards. And Hallmark had to be very sharp to get back and drag his pad against the post. For Hallmark, these games can be tough as well. You're talking to yourself a lot in net, trying to stay in it with limited work that he has had to date.
A back-to-back situation for the Bruins as they'll host the Flyers tomorrow.
And I would imagine you'll see Tuukka Rask.
It is a possibility that he gets a start as Hallmark gets that one in his glove.
JackpotCity.net. Casino games perfectly made for you.
If all goes well, Cassidy said he will get the net tomorrow night. And of course, they were hoping he'd get a couple of games in Providence before his NHL start this season, but COVID stopped that idea.
Here's Armia with Drouin going to the net. Pass across, and Drouin trying to draw a call, and he gets one. And the Canadiens will get their first crack of the power play tonight on the slashing call.
Well, Boston get caught here going into the zone a little bit too fancy in the big line, and Bergeron's going to end up with the penalty, I believe, on the play. But it's before that is Marchand here. He gets a little bit too tricky on the turn back, loses an edge, and now the Montreal Canadiens have numbers going back in the 2-on-1. And there's the penalty right there on the back check. And Patrice Bergeron will go in the box for two or less. And a teammate makes a mistake. Guess who's the first forward back? And if you're wondering why everybody says
the best, or one of the best, defensive forwards in the National Hockey League.
And this power play is brought to you by Kit Kat Chunky, made for hunger. Brandon Carlo after the puck as it bounced around on the boards. Nick Suzuki will get it. He'll drop it to the point. Sherrod is on it. Played for Hoffman. Hoffman back to the point for Sherrod. Out of the cross on the wing. Here's Hoffman with room. Shoots. Kicked out by Allmark. And then he had Paling in the crease to bump him. And the puck ends up down the ice.
Well, this Montreal power play, it's 32nd in the league. Dead last. And Hoffman, who they were hoping would be a big contributor to that power play, has not played a lot this season, and he's out there now, and they'll try to tee him up for his one-timer. He's got a great one.
Eight straight games without a power play goal for the Canadiens on an 0-for-19 run in those eight games as Hoffman's shot is blocked, and Bleed will get it back down the ice. There comes Hoffman with speed through center. Drops it back. Petrie follows up. Played it in off the boards. Turned over on the Bruins. Get it back down the ice. Montembeau went to play it, and that got broken up by DeBrusk on the forecheck. Petrie on it once more. Jeff Petrie will lay it back for Armia. Yoel Armia up the center onto the wing for Weidman. Armia going after it. In comes Dvorak. Armia then was caught up back in the net with Lakanainen, and it's cleared back down the ice as Montembeau will leave it. Petrie on it once more. Jeff Petrie gets his way into the Bruins zone. Left to Demo with a snapshot right on, and it's into the glove of Linus Allmark.
So Hoffman is responsible for this kind of chance, if you will, here that gets through. That's a good chance, actually, with Paling in front of the net. Hoffman gets it through, and I mentioned that big shot of his when he's playing the way he can. There it is. And he can beat goalies from that dot on his one-timer. And he's got a pretty good release as well, as he shows you there. The problem is, when he's the only weapon, teams will gang up on you, and he doesn't get that room that we just saw him get there most nights, especially when you don't have a player like Petrie producing from the back end.
Sherrod at his pocket pick by Marchand, trying to get it in front, thrown on him. Montembeau makes the stop. Sherrod will clear it out. Savard up for Lekkonen, stood up at the line by Brandon Carlo. And Al Marchand down the wing, cuts into the middle. Brad Marchand with a shot, and he zipped it wide. Thrown back on net, and Montembeau will make the save, and he holds on.
And Montembeau, he can't fault him on the goal that he let in late in period number one. He's been pretty sharp. And Patrice Bergeron with the great forecheck. Now it's the bouncing puck, and guess who? Marchand again steals the puck with that great speed, and then the good chance here by Smith, and there's a pretty good-looking save. And how about Carlo? He gets one of those a game where he'll stand somebody up like that and come up with a big hit, and he does it there.
Ball knocked down on the draw, but won it. Grizzlick will hand it across for McAvoy. Taylor Hall back for Grizzlick. Away from Pasternak. Picked up by Holla. Knocked down by Suzuki. Has the puck underneath him. Holla trying to spin around on the boards, and he got it as Grizzlick had a shot from the line. Paquette is on it. He'll hand it off as Suzuki will work his way in on the wing. Cedric Paquette picks it up, goes back in the net for Suzuki. Knocked down by Grizzlick, throws it in front. Hoffman trying to get it up in the air. Paquette's side of the goal, couldn't jam at it. Penalty coming up here. It's a hooking call against the Bruins as Hoffman and Paquette had a couple of chances.
I heard Justin and Anthony talking about Suzuki here, and Hoffman, he shows you that tenacity that he does. Draws a penalty with a strong forecheck.
Well, Montreal with a couple of opportunities to try and get on the board. They'll have a power play when we return on Scotiabank.
Great job getting the puck in front, and then Hoffman hunts down the puck, and there is that little puck right there by Holla, and he's in the box.
Armia hands it off. Country, Drouin fires, and it's off the post and out of play. Jonathan Drouin looking for his first power play goal in over 2 years, and he rings it off the iron.
Nice looking pass here in the one-timer. Hallmark is clearly beat, and yeah, that's the way it's been going, isn't it?
Jonathan Drouin hasn't scored a power play goal since October 19, 2019. It's 90 straight games without a power play goal, 20 shots and over 206 minutes of power play time. And he nearly snapped that streak right there. Missed it by that much. Here comes Bergeron the other way. Hands it off. Moore with a shot. Handcuff Montembeau scores! Brad Marchand, the hat trick. Short-handed goal.
And here come the hats. It's the little things that kill you in this league. It's such a close league. The Montreal Canadiens win the draw. They get it back to the point. Petrie drags it to the middle, and the puck gets deflected and it misses the net. They lose puck recovery. Now you go the other way. And guess who? Marchand just comes cruising right down the middle of the ice after Moore, the defenseman, joins the play. And three Montreal Canadiens chase the puck instead of the player coming late. And it's 4-0 Boston.
Fifth career hat trick for Brad Marchand. His last one was April 4th, 2021 against Pittsburgh. And is he on a tear right now or what?
Well, we had it early. He's been doing this the last number of weeks where he's got that extra hop to his game, and he's been absolutely spectacular. And oh boy, you got to feel for this guy. It's not easy. And there's the initial shot. Look at Brad Marchand. I mean, he just goes right down the middle. Armia just lets him go. And obviously, the rebound comes right on the tape, and there's the shorty.
And now, Dominic Ducharme called referee Chris Lee over to have a word with him, and they're just having a conversation at the Canadiens bench. Well, 19 goals on the season now for Brad Marchand. 8 goals over the last 4 games. In fact, Marchand's 8 goals in the last 4 games are more goals than anyone in the Canadiens lineup has scored all season so far.
Montreal have to go down to Chicago, Arizona, Dallas, Las Vegas, Denver, Minnesota. And that's the road trip coming up. Man.
And in Chicago tomorrow night. Suzuki for Poehling. Played back to the net. Cole Caulfield trying to come up with a puck in the corner. Hoffman after it. Poehling left it for Caulfield. Back for Poehling. He's hit from behind by Carlo, and he is slow to get back to his feet. And then a big check is Sherratt with a heavy hit at the blue line. And we've got a whistle here and a penalty, and I think that's going to be an interference call against Ben Sherratt.
Frustration's mounting. And a veteran player. There's the shoot in, and maybe the elbow up. Let's see what he calls here. Roughing, they're going to call. I don't know if I love that call, but at any rate, maybe a little high. Ducharme was really complaining about a play, and we caught up to it. It's Marchand coming out of the zone, gives Armia a little tug to get through and break through the neutral zone. And we'll try to catch up to that in a moment for you. But that's what he was worried about and complaining to the referee about. And then Armia, of course, arrived late, and Marchand tucked it in the net.
Here's Kulak with it. Turns back. 21 seconds to go on the 4-on-4. Kulak through center on his own, trying to get through three Bruins here. Poked back to net. Grizzlick is there. Checked by Dvorak. Charlie Coyle. Trying to skate away from Jonathan Drouin. And now Coyle has got it. He'll bring it into the Canadian zone. Played it across. Grizzlick with a shot. It's off the stick handle of Montembeau. Riley will feed it over to Grizzlick. Back for DeBrusk. Petrie comes up with it. Jeff Petrie will loop the net and take off with it. Petrie on his own here in the Boston zone. Rolls it around. And that'll come all the way back out with a minute to go on the Boston power play. Grizzlick up for Marchand. Brad Marchand trying to work his way in the zone and does. Dropped it back for Bergeron. Marchand to the point. Pasternak with it. He'll hand it off. McAvoy right in front, and a drive by Bergeron. Stopped by Montembeau.
Terrific puck movement here by the Boston Bruins. And the secret to all successful power play opportunities is moving it quickly, letting the puck do the work. And this is an example of it here to a T. Bing, bang, boom. And Montembeau with the shot. Now here's what the coach was complaining about. There is Marchand with that little tug, and that puts him in position. But Armia still, I mean, he stops. Even though you get tugged in the neutral zone, you got to keep going. And a smart little veteran play by Marchand.
Now here's McAvoy handing it off. Bergeron to Marchand. Back for Bergeron. And Marchand in the corner with it. Trying to get it in front. Bruce tucked in. Bergeron sends it over. Pasternak with a shot. Montembeau the save. He keeps the play going as Paquette tried to move it. Turned over. Taylor Hall falls. Fed it to the point. McAvoy hands it off. Pass in behind Hall. Taylor Hall dumped it down for Pasternak. Rolled up the boards by Sammy Niku. And that'll get out and down the ice. And that'll do it for the power play. McAvoy up to center. Sherratt is out of the box. Here's Pasternak. Throws it over. Tended for Taylor Hall, who's broken up. Moore to the net. Bouncing puck. And the Canadians get it back as Sherratt will clear it out. Linus Ullmark moves it around the wing. Jeff Petrie hands it off, and it's worked on through center now and brought in by Ryan Palin. Lost it. Kulak will play it off for Petrie. Right back for Pezzetta. Lifts it in. Moore goes after it. Back it on him. Checked in the corner by Pezzetta. Suzuki tries to come out front. A scramble for it. It'll skip to the point. Kulak fires. That hit a body. Pezzetta scores! Michael Pezzetta spins and fires it home, and the Canadians are on the board.
Well, Suzuki again. I mean, he gets puck possession behind the net, tries to take it to the tough area, does that, but then the puck ends up right back to the point. And Pezzetta here blocks it, knocks it down on the point shot attempt, and then a real nice turn back shot, a rolling puck, so he's able to get it up in a hurry off the post and in. And the Montreal Canadiens here get a little confidence as they get on the board. But terrific work once again by Suzuki to hunt down the puck and start that offensive chance.
Puck rolled into the corner. Pezzetta with his second of the year as Nosek will play it off the glass. Sherratt knocked it loose. Here's Hoffman. Back of the goal for Suzuki. To Hoffman again. The point. Weidman. For Lekkonen. Lekkonen right in front, and he put it onto the stick of Lazar. Hazard dumps it in. Reed going after it, tangled up by Weidman. Now there's a chance. Quick shot by Bergeron. Comes right back for Hoffman. He'll clear it out. That one ends up into the Canadiens bench by the looks of it. We'll get a whistle. Well, after a 4-0 lead for the Bruins, Michael Pezzetta has the Canadiens on the board on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey on Sports Now.
Well, it's an easy one, isn't it? We know who's hungry. Brad Marchand has been absolutely spectacular the last number of weeks, and yeah, I mean, the puck is just following him right now. Everything he does seems to be working for him, but he earns it. He works hard. He's in all those tough areas every game. He competes, and he can pick up a hat for his services here so far tonight.
Marchand with his fifth career hat trick. Only two current Bruins have more with the franchise. David Pastrnak with 10 and Patrice Bergeron with 7. Marchand, the 14th different player in Bruins history to score a hat trick versus the Canadiens in their long-standing rivalry, as Grizzlick and Pezzetta run into each other back in there. McAvoy going after Pezzetta, and then he is grabbed here, and everyone's going to pile in as Bergeron went back after Pezzetta.
And this is what Pezzetta will do. He'll try and get under the skin of the opponents. He's not afraid to drop the gloves at all. He does it this time. But give the captain credit. I mean, once again, Bergeron shows his leadership abilities. He sees what happens. He reacts to stick up for his teammate. Well, there was the initial contact there that Patrice Bergeron didn't like. And he's going to get the penalty for roughing, but I can tell you, everybody on that Boston bench will tell you that's a good penalty.
So the Canadiens will get their third power play of the game, as they allowed the shorthanded goal on the last power play opportunity. It was the fourth shorthanded goal allowed by Montreal this season, and the third. Or yeah, fourth, excuse me. Yep, fourth shorthanded goal allowed. But now they've got the power play here as Petrie will hand it off, and it's picked up by Dvorak. Feeds it for Drouin with a shot. Stopped by Hallmark. He thought he had it, but it came around on the wing. Weidman trying to get to it. Back to the point. Here's Petrie. Jeff Petrie for Drouin. Shoots off the head of Ullmark and out of play. He's getting his looks on the power play this game, and now we've got Brandon Carlo with extra words for Pezzetta.
Yeah, this isn't over yet by any means. And another faceoff win by Montreal. Of course, Patrice Bergeron in the penalty box. That hurts the penalty kill for Boston. And there's the one-timer and the second time from that spot that they've had a pretty good chance, as Durant lets it rip. And I think Ullmark, you're right, got a hunk of that.
Nosek won the draw. Carlo trying to play it, taken away by Jonathan Drouin. Off the boards, back to the point. Here's Petrie with it. Jeff Petrie down the wing. And he'll send it all the way back for Drouin. Hands it off for Dvorak, over to Weidman. Back for Jonathan Drouin with a shot. It's blocked. Weidman for Drouin. Weak pass, broken up. And the Bruins will get it to center as Carlo takes his time with it and now rolls it in deep. Petrie waits back in the net. Canadiens make a change. Petrie dropped it back, and it's Suzuki that'll carry it up. Flipped it in, stopped by McAvoy. Here goes Marchand after it. He'll stop, looks for a little help, flipped it in front, couldn't get it to Eric Halla. And Nick Suzuki will take off with it. Suzuki up onto the wing, Kalen gets it in. Suzuki on the puck. Played it back for Caulfield, rolled it around. Hoffman to the point. Chiarot back into the corner. Kalen goes after it. Suzuki played it out for Sherratt. He'll take the shot, and that one made it through, and Hallmark got a piece of it. Hailing pin to the boards by Riley. McAvoy will draw the penalty on Nick Suzuki. It'll be a holding call that will send Suzuki to the box.
Yeah, clearly a penalty here. Suzuki, who's done such a nice job in this period on the forecheck,
number 14,
gets caught
for holding,
throwing his arm out and being a little bit too aggressive on this forecheck. Right there. And McAvoy can't continue his forward progress, and Suzuki gets caught with that free arm out.
So it'll be 9 seconds of four-on-four hockey. And then Boston will go to the power play as Savard comes up with it. Doesn't get it out. Pastrnak trying to hang on to it. They'll set it up for Grizzly. Back for Pastrnak. Broken up by Sherratt. Ben Sherratt on his own, shorthanded down the wing. Lost a handle on it, gets it back, and he'll just take it to the corner and try to burn out a few seconds here as Grizzly trying to chop it away. Sherratt took exception to that. Riley, long pass ahead, tipped in. The demo goes after it as Montembeau will play it around the boards. Here's McAvoy, off for Marchand. Brad Marchand to McAvoy, cross for Pastrnak. Back for Marchand, took it in his skates. Now he's got it. Watched by Paquette, played it for Bergeron. His pass intercepted. Worked off the boards and out as Pastrnak will pick it up. Lost it, and a break here, shorthanded. Dauphin put it off the post. Laurent Dauphin with a great chance. To get a shorthanded marker for the Canadiens. Pastrnak up with it. And Dauphin will find it at center and flip it in.
You know, that was a poor change by the Montreal Canadiens. I mean, Dauphin, the only reason he was wide open is they changed the forward when the puck was in their own zone trying to kill a penalty. Albeit, it almost worked.
Bergeron will drop it back. Grizzly hands it off. Vakanainen back to Grizzly. Plays it across. Taylor Hall with a shot. Montembeau the stop. He'll cover it up in front as Bergeron was on the doorstep.
So Montreal here, a forward takes off, Dauphin on the player's bench, and that's why he sneaks in behind McAvoy and rattles one right off the poster. We almost had this gap being closed after Pastrnak gave it away right inside or outside the blue line. And there is the chance, and almost a shorthanded goal for the Montreal Canadiens.
Two goal posts this period for Montreal. One on the power play and one shorthanded. There's Grizzly for Vakanainen. Walks in, trying to feed it in front for Craig Smith. Grizzly. Back for Taylor Hall. Off to Grizzly. He'll shoot off a few sticks. Never made it to the net. Taylor Hall back for Smith. Blockered away by Montembeau. Another chance. Vakanainen with a shot. It's into the glove of Montembeau. And he holds on. Laurent Dauphin looking for his second of the season, but he can't beat the iron in a 4-1 Bruins lead.
No surprise. This guy gets right into that area where you get score goals in this league, and that's why he scores so many. 28, right in that hot area, if you will, which a lot of players don't like going to. And you can tell by his face, he goes there a fair bit. That nose has been worked on a few times.
Here's Lazar with a quick shot. Grabbed by Montembeau, and he'll hold on. And now Weidman and Gleed will mix things up side of the net. Should mention the Bruins are a man short on defense right now. John Moore went to the Bruins dressing room, has not returned after taking a hit from Michael Pezzetta, so we'll keep an eye on that. Hailing there for the draw against Nosek as it's flipped up by Weidman. Gleed had him all tangled up. Pezzetta off for Caulfield. Caulfield after it. Lazar will work it around to the corner. The boards and out down the ice, and that'll be an icing call. Oh, and then Reed then gets a little extra shove after the whistle.
This is getting a little heated, and it all really started with this Pezzetta play behind the net here. Not that one. That was a little later, but there's the one on Moore that put him down. So Pezzetta's been active this period. Of course, he was involved in that other hit behind the net that Patrice Bergeron didn't like.
Failing tangled up with Lazar off the draw, and it is Anton Pleed that'll get it at center. Flipped it in. After it goes, Nicu. Bumped by Nosa. Failing trying to find it. Cleared away and back down the ice by the Canadians as Brandon Carlo's back on the puck. He'll drop it off for Vaakanainen. Savard stands up his man as Hoffman will throw it to the open wing. Lazar jumps after it. Played it down for DeBrusk. The boards to the point. Riley there. Throws it in front. It's stopped by Sherratt. Here's Coyle. Shoots through traffic. Up in the air. Knocked down by Coyle. Left it back for Riley. Hands it up for Steen. In tight. Coyle's backhand missed. Charlie McAvoy backpedals along the line. Hands it off, and it is forced out at center as Coyle had to turn away from Palin. Riley got it up ahead, and it's played into the Canadian zone. Montembeau will clear it himself onto the stick of Hoffman at center ice. Suzuki trying to catch up to it, throws it in front, and Luckinen didn't have a stick down to receive it. Now Hoffman trying to get it back to the middle. Cleared by Steen. Petrie on it. Jeff Petrie. That's the center. Fires it in. Grzelcyk reverses it back the other way. Cut off though. As Dvorak will poke it behind the net. Drouin to the point. Petrie shoots, tipped in front as Dvorak got a piece of it. And Hallmark forced to track that one.
It's funny how it works. You know, some players, you get a little life against the team, and maybe you like playing against the team because of the style of play that they played. Pezzetta gets his first NHL goal against the Boston Bruins November 14th. And then this game, of course, he's been extremely physical being involved here. Getting a goal and also just being involved physically. So interesting how sometimes a player has a little luck against the team and it carries over.
Puck lifted into the Canadiens' end. Throwing in front, Marchand with a chance for number four on the feed from Bergeron. Petrie dumps it back into the corner. Brandon Carlo going after it. Delphin trying to reach in there on Carlo to knock it loose. Drouin kicks it free. Delphin back to the point. Here's Kulak with a shot goes wide, and Marchand is after it. Flipped it up. Weidman knocked it down. Here's Dvorak with a shot right on. Stop, main rebound. And Goffin knocked it out of the air. Almost got a piece of it. Kicked loose in front again, but Marchand is there. And Boston is on the attack as Riley will bring it in. Weidman up for Goffin. Missed it. Marchand for Pasternak for Hall. Across for Eric Halla. And a whistle here. Sure, why? Oh, we've got a penalty coming up. Kulak will go to the box for high sticking or slashing.
Montreal penalty.
Here's the chance by Marchand as well, and Bergeron on the forecheck. And that those two have combined all game long. And then at the other end, Allmark had to be very sharp. Montreal has not gone away in this period. They had several good looks, and Allmark has had to be sharp here a couple of times in the last 5 or 6 minutes. And give Montreal credit. I mean, they're understaffed. They haven't played since January 1st. They're down by 3, but they're hanging around this game. And then the slash penalty is right there. And Kulak will go to the penalty box.
Here's McAvoy. Played it across the road in front as Hall got a piece of it looking for the tip. Marchand checked. And the Canadians clear it down the ice. McAvoy is on it. Hands it off, and it is brought up by Pastrnak. He'll play it across out of the wing. Bergeron in front, off the stick of Savard. Taylor Hall in a battle for it. Marchand kept it in. McAvoy with it. Dropped it off. Here's Bergeron to Marchand. He'll shoot, and it's blocked and ends up out of play. NBA action continues on the network tomorrow when the LA Clippers pay a visit to the New Orleans Pelicans. Coverage begins at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on Sportsnet 360 and Sportsnet Now.
Coach Cassidy's got a pretty nice advantage here on his power play units because he's got Grizzlick on one power play unit from the point and McAvoy on the other, and they can both really fire the puck. They can also walk the blue line extremely well, and he'll use both of them throughout the two-minute segment on a power play. And that's a nice advantage to have for a coach, to have two power play quarterbacks on separate units on the power play. Grizzlick, of course, with 5 points against the Washington Capitals a couple of nights ago.
Now Coyle in to take the draw. Great story with Grizzlick getting those points. Here's a drive right on Montembeau with a stop, and we'll have another faceoff.
Yeah, grew up at the old Boston Garden. His dad, who I've known for years, he used to chirp me when I was a net in the old garden because he's one of the men on the ice crew in Boston. So Grizzlick grew up watching the Boston Bruins, who an undrafted player, and here he is in the National Hockey League and being a big factor for this organization now. And Cassidy, you know, appreciates that.
Bergeron will line up for the draw against Dvorak. Comes right to Montembeau. He directs it to the corner. Sherratt goes after it. Savard has got it, and that'll do it. 15-9, the shots in favor of the Bruins in the second period. Pezzetta with a goal for Montreal to get him on the board, but Brad Marchand with a hat trick, the story in this game so far. Carolyn Cameron, Anthony Stewart, Justin Bourne coming up in our intermission on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey on Sportsnet.
In that first period, it could have been really ugly. It was looking like it was going to get that way, and then they fought and battled really hard that second period. And, you know, they're hanging around. I mean, it's a long way back, but they are hanging around in this game still, to their credit.
Sam Montembeau coming in to take over for Jake Allen. John Moore has not returned for the Bruins after taking that hit from Michael Pezzetta, who is the goal scorer for the Canadiens. He won't return tonight, as the Bruins have officially announced that. So let's see what we've got in store here for period number three on this Wednesday night at TD Garden. Coyle will play it back in the net. Grizzlick is on it. And he'll start out with it. Drops it off. Worked across for Charlie Coyle. Up ahead for Craig Smith. Coyle tried to jump out of the pass. He ended up kicking it towards the net. It's lifted down the ice, and that'll end up right on Allmark. So no icing as Grizzlick is on it again. Coyle. Out of the wing. Brought in now as DeBrusque's got it. Whoa, whoa, look out indeed. And we've got a penalty here as Armia is at the bottom of the pile.
So we'll see. The call's obviously going to be tripping,
Boston,
I would imagine.
12, 2 minutes for tripping.
Yep. Yes. Smith with the penalty, and clearly there is a trip as he takes the feet with his stick to Amir and hauls him down.
So a power play here for the Canadians in 26 seconds.
Correct.
Scramble off the draw. Bergeron got it back. Canadians are on it, though. There's Drouin for Petrie. Petrie will send it across. Drouin back to Petrie. Now to Nikku, fires, and that one ends up out of play.
There's the general manager of, well, the president, I suppose. What's his title?
President?
Executive VP.
Executive VP.
There you are.
Operators. There you go.
There, thank you very much, guys. Jeff Gordon. I think he's going to be GM as well, and they'll bring somebody in to call him a GM, but you know that Gordon will be directly involved in player movement for the Montreal Canadiens. I don't think there's any doubt about that. And they'll find a French-speaking manager to complement Gordon in that role.
Marchand around the net. Wyman goes down. Marchand still on the puck, trying to get it out front. And now Wyman will hand it off for Petrie. Back to Wyman. Canadiens trying to set things up here with a man advantage.
And I believe it was Gordon that brought Tuukka Rask to Montreal as well when he was with the Boston Bruins organization.
To Boston.
Or to Boston.
Pardon me.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah.
From Toronto in the...
Yeah, in that trade. I believe that was him that made that trade. And
the Andrew Raycroft trade.
That's good news for Montreal Canadian fans looking ahead. Still sore news for Toronto Maple Leaf fans.
The choice at the time was Tuukka Rask with Justin Pogge, who to deal to Boston for Andrew Raycroft, and they decided to trade Tuukka Rask, who has now become the all-time wins leader for the Boston Bruins in net. Eric Halla will play it off the boards, back in. Sherrod is on it. 24 seconds to go on the power play as Sherrod will hand it off, drop back, and here comes Suzuki to Ryan Poehling. Broke it up, Eric Halla's there, and he'll clear it down the ice. Sherrod, one last rush here. Connects with Cole Caulfield on the wing. Caulfield, back behind the net. Knocks it around the boards. Ryan Poehling's there to the point. Rolling shot. Fired towards the net by Savard as Sherrod goes after it. Riley's got it. He'll lift it in the air and out. Caught up by Craig Smith. He tried to play it in front. Lazar dumps it in. Smith after it. Hosek is on. Takes the hit. And Hoffman will drop it back as Sherrod will get it up for Yoel Armia. Cross ice pass. Hoffman tried to catch it off the boards. Didn't work. Back and on him to Taylor Hall. He's on his own with the Canadiens. End points in the middle of a chain. Vedemo hands it off for Armia. Yoel Armia checked by Hall as he was skating back. Here's Pasternak now up with it. He'll stop. Vedemo will push it back to the goal. Armia goes after it. Hall there to take it away. Eric Halla up with it. Down in front as he tried to connect with Pasternak. Kulak, a little too far for Dauphin. Pasternak will play it back in, and Sammy Nikku has got it.
I would imagine with a three-goal lead now, Boston's just going to try to manage this game for the next 15 minutes, not get themselves in any problems in terms of their defensive structure. And if the opportunity presents itself, they'll take off offensively on a counterattack.
There's a chance in tight for DeBrus. Couldn't get the shot to go. Charlie Coyle.
Or a giveaway.
Fired on net by Steen, and Montembeau will make the save.
Dawn Power Wash saves you time from scrubbing dishes. Simply spray, wipe, and rinse to clean as you go.
Coyle and Dvorak. Overdraw. Knocked back out at center, and a race for it here as McAvoy is on it. Pezetta giving chase. McAvoy will send it around the wing, and it comes back for Sammy Nikku. Being watched by Steen. Nikku checked by DeBrus. Nikku's got it. Long pass ahead. Could connect with Pezetta. Oscar Steen will play it back in. Nyku has a look over his shoulder, and he'll move the puck around the boards with DeBrusk coming. Now Riley on it. There's Riley. Handing it back. Tipped out for Bergeron. Thrown in wide. Marchand going after it. Hoffman right on him. Sammy Nyku lays it up for Nick Suzuki, and he'll lift it in. That'll be an icing call.
So Nozick against the boards here, a little bit of a puck battle. Gets shoved into the boards by Savard. Seems to be okay there, but maybe that's just an equipment thing or getting reorganized on the bench. He seems to be okay, or maybe he just pulled a muscle there when he was getting that contact, but seems to be okay.
Nyku trying to win the battle with Marchand as Kulak's got it. He'll lift into the air and out. And that one ends up four rows into the seats behind the Bruins bench.
Well, this Boston Bruin team, they're 8-3-2 in their last 13. Allmark's won four in a row in net. And they're running on all cylinders. I'm looking at this group, though, thinking about, you know, now they're thinking that way, Stanley Cup. I think they got to add at least a defenseman, a steady guy with some physical play to his collection, and then maybe another centerman, perhaps a second center iceman if you could find it, is a bit of an upgrade, but that's a pretty tall order.
Another penalty coming up to Boston here, and now Lekkonen's going to go after Marchand, and everyone will pile in.
Well, there's been some unlikely candidates tonight that have got involved in this. I mean, Lekkonen, you don't see that from him ever. And Patrice Bergeron will get involved physically, but not against a guy like Pezzetta normally. Yeah, it looks like Boston's going to end up with a two-minute penalty as Marchand's going to get it here for this play on Suzuki there. Interference will be the call. And the Boston faithful don't like it much, but I knew he wouldn't.
Suzuki looks no worse for the wear.
Yeah, he's been the best Montreal Canadian for me tonight by far. Not even close, Suzuki.
Power play number five for the Canadians in this game as Pezzetta goes after the puck. Dropped it back to the point for Petrie. They try to set things up. Drouin for Petrie with a shot through traffic goes wide. Weidman lifts it over the glass. Sports streaming has been redefined with the all-new Sportsnet Now. Stream over 1,000 games, Hockey Night in Canada, Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey, the Stanley Cup Playoffs, the NHL Draft, and much more. Visit snnow.ca and start streaming the NHL season today.
Well, no Josh Anderson out tonight, of course. No Toffoli. You can probably add Jake Evans to that as well. Power play guy, kind of. Really not much from their back end in terms of offense. And you get a power play that's sputtering for the Montreal Canadiens, and you get Pezzetta on it. And that tells you all you need to know about personnel on the power play, with all due respect to him.
Pezzetta goes after the puck in the corner. Boyle's got it held against the boards. Now it's a rugby scrum, and everyone's in there. The battle here for it.
Nope, anything left of the puck after this.
Yeah.
One.
It's going to come out square.
Oh, let's get another guy in there.
There we go. Take the whistle. Let's change that puck. And now everyone's going to pile in as well.
You know, rarely they call this and blow it down, but it got to the point here where they had to. Is either team could fish it out, and now we're getting some more of it.
Yeah, Hull is going after Weidman here.
Again, two players that never do this. I don't know what's going on tonight.
Now we've got glove flying in the air. Someone's trying to grab Pezzetta, I believe, as Holly gets helped off. It was Brandon Carlo going after Pezzetta in the corner. And they're both going to go too. So referee Chris Lee will clean this up a little.
Well, there's Weidman getting his gloves up, and Paula didn't like it much, so he came in. And then that turned into a pretty good wrestling match by the end of it. And, oh, there's a headbutt. Hello.
And that's what had Holla so
no wonder he lost him.
Yeah, and that's what the referees are discussing now. John McIsaac and Chris Lee talking to linesman Derek Manson and Corey.
I mean, that was clearly a headbutt. So here they are. The referees are at it at the penalty box, having a pretty good little discussion. Cassidy, of course, has the video, so he's going to have somebody over to plead the case. So it just ends up in the boards. Nobody can seem to fish the puck out. This Coyle there has got it pinned really well against the boards, and then it seemed like a harmless play, even when the whistle went. And then Weidman got a little bit aggressive. You'll see this in a moment here.
It went on for 28 seconds, this scrum.
Wow. And there's Weidman with the shove there, the pile. And then after that, Paula came in, and before you know it, we got this mess going on.
John McIsaac explaining the situation. Derek Manson over at the Canadiens bench. And it looked like Chris Lee had said unsportsmanlike conduct, one of the calls in there, explaining to the penalty box. And it's going to be 4-on-4. The Canadiens were on the power play here, so they've taken the additional minor out of all this.
Marchand looks really excited about it all.
Oh, yes. And the faceoff will come back to the Canadiens' end.
Everybody looks a little confused at the moment here, trying to sort this out.
By the way, just to go back to what you were saying earlier about Jeff Gorton, he ran that 2006 NHL entry draft, which produced Phil Kessel, Milan Lucic, and Brad Marchand. And then at that same draft, of course, traded Ray Kroft to the Leafs.
How's that?
To Rask.
So for Montreal Canadian fans, if you hear that, you have to be somewhat enthusiastic about the hire. It'll be interesting to see in the next couple of weeks, if it becomes the next couple of weeks, who they hire to be the, well, the title of general manager at least.
There's Petrie up with it. He'll get it up for Hoffman. Hoffman is center. Dumps it into the corner. Comes off the boards quickly with Suzuki on it. Lifts it towards it. And Allmark to stop. So roughing for everyone. And Weidman got the additional unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. And that's how he ended up 4-on-4 with a Bruins power play coming up in 15 seconds. Here's Suzuki after it. Checked in the corner by Vaakanainen, tried to get it in front. Taylor Hall on the puck. Tied up along the boards, kicked to the point by Sherrod. Hoffman has got it. Here's Hoffman, back for Sherrod, shoots, and Omar comes out and blocked it.
Hall got a stick in the face from Suzuki that was missed.
Oh, And now it's Marchand with speed through center into the Canadian zone. Stops, dropped it off for Pasternak. Hands it across, one-time shot by McAvoy, stopped by Montembeau.
Yeah, Suzuki gets a stick up here on Hall. He goes down for a moment now. They're trying to draw the penalty or get asked for the penalty. There is the stick there, right in the chin.
That was Sherrod's stick.
Yeah, that was Sherrod, as it turns out, yeah. And then Hallmark here with a very awkward-looking save. And he can play like that sometimes, but nobody cares as long as it doesn't go in the net.
Here's McAvoy with it, hands it off. And the try by Pasternak is wide. Marchand with it. Down low for Taylor Hall. Right in front, Bergeron bouncing puck, couldn't settle it down. McAvoy for Pasternak. Pasternak with a shot, and that one creams off the leg of Hall in front. It'll come around the wing, and that is out of the zone.
It may not happen right away, but if Rask comes back healthy and playing the way he can, I don't think you'll see much of Allmark down the stretch at all, to be honest.
Here's Pasternak trying to cut his way in. Up by Savard. Right in front, pressure all on, and he couldn't put it in behind Montembeau. Got a piece of it. McAvoy trying to hold the line. Vedemo will battle it out. Here's Sherratt back on it. And an offside called against the Canadians.
I'll play with the group I play with my whole career and have another chance to win. You know, that's about it.
And that was clear from day one after Tuukka Rask announced that he had to have surgery on his hip, that if teams even entertain the fact that they may be able to get the unrestricted free agent when he was healthy, he just shut that right down and said, nope, if I'm playing anywhere, it's with the Boston Bruins, and I'm going to finish my career there, and I think we got a chance. He backed it up, didn't he?
Certainly did with this contract, and now we'll see what happens. Here come the Bruins again as Riley will backhand it in. Steen going after it. Oscar Steen tied up in the corner by Brett Kulak. Ryan Palin comes in to try and jar it loose. DeBrusk, held back by Petrie, comes up with a puck. Got it off the boards. Riley from the point with a drive right on. And now Kulak, a little shoving match here with Steen. And not much more will come of that.
And Rask with Hall of Fame numbers, really, as a Boston Bruin. Regular season wins for the all-time rank as a Bruin. And they have had some pretty darn good goalies go through with Boston. Playoff wins, number one. It's another big number when you think of all the playoff rounds that the Boston Bruin organization had. Jerry Cheevers comes to mind a lot. And, yeah, that Stanley Cup that everybody's trying to chase as well as part of his resume.
So Arnold will hand it off for Miku. Got it up on the wing. Pezzetta helps it out. There's Grizzly. Out of his own end with it. Up to center, they'll feed it ahead. Lazar with a chance, his shot goes off a stick. Anton Bleed follows up to the point. Back and on, and shoot scores! Kanainen has his first NHL goal, and that's a moment to remember.
And there's the smile to go with it. A first rounder way back in 2017, and he's taken some time to develop with this Bruin organization. He's played very well of late, and this is just a miss by Montebello, who's been very good. And that might have hit Lazar. You wonder if it hits Lazar here from that angle.
I don't know, or if it just went through his legs, yeah. And that's why Montembeau couldn't track
it. He was first on the victory train at the bench, but not Lazar.
No, but Vakanainen was, yeah. At the moment, it's credited to Vakanainen.
As I mentioned, that they've been very patient, Boston, with Vakanainen, you know, waiting for him to develop in the American Hockey League. They've taken some time with him in Europe. And the 2017 first-round pick is starting to pay dividends now for the team. And for Montembeault on that play, like, he's been pretty good since he's come in for the Canadians in relief of Jake Allen. If you missed it, Allen went out early or midway through the, or late the first period, really, with a groin injury, we think.
Cave and Primo on the trip. And for the game in Chicago tomorrow, expect Primo to rejoin the lineup.
Yeah, and Primo.
And Suzuki with a little late bump on Marchand.
Yep.
Right at the whistle, that'll just draw a little crowd.
And Primo's played pretty well the last while for the Montreal Canadiens after having a bit of a difficult start to the season, looking at that point like he wasn't ready, but he's played much better.
So the Bruins with a four-goal lead here in Boston as things have been a little feisty tonight on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey.
That angle, I don't think it touched Lazar. And by his reaction, he goes right back to the defenseman. And knowing Curtis Lazar the way I do, knowing him as a kid when he played for the Ottawa Senators, he's a terrific teammate. And even if he did maybe nick it, he wouldn't change that goal, believe me, if he had anything to do with it. It's the kind of guy he is.
Sherratt. Play it back. Savard got it out at center. It stopped and worked back in. Savard trying to poke it up away from Steen. Oscar Steen. Bumped by Savard. Oh, now the Bruins fans are getting in on the trolling action here a bit on the Canadiens. Here is a chance for Carlo with a shot. And Montembeault got a piece of it. Steen in front, and that one got away from Coyle. DeBrusk tried to get it down to the side. Broken up. Sherratt is on it.
A lot of history between these two organizations, and fans don't forget. And they're having a little fun right now with their team up and dominating this game against Montreal. Kicking the player, kicking them when they're down, what they're doing. And kicking pretty hard at the moment.
Here's McAvoy. Playing it up ahead. Pasternak up through center. Feeds it off. Taylor Hall got it across. And a great chance for Grizzlick is stopped by Montembeault.
Montembeault, as I've mentioned throughout this game since coming in relief, I mean, this could be a lot worse if it wasn't for him. And here's a pretty good looking save there. Wow. As he gets his pad out on DeBrusk. And DeBrusk just fails to get it past the toe of Montembeault. And then the next shift, another good reaction save as Grizzlick was in position A, right in the slot, left wide open.
Here's McAvoy trying to send it across, and Hall got a piece of it, but the pass the wrong way as Drouin will dump it in. It's off the backboards, right in front. Jonathan Drouin with a backhand. All marked the stop. Drouin. Voroniku off his stick to center. And now here's Nosek going to the net, and he stepped to the short side. Riley with it. Got it in over the line. Pasternak trying to find it. Picked up though by the Canadians as Nick Suzuki will bring it back into the Bruins' end. Backhand pass in front, and Lekkonen going to the net. Not just a piece of it. Now the fans chanting, "We want Tuukka." So they're happy to have their netminder back. Lekkonen will dump it in. Here's Savard with it. Armia will get it out. Bademo will work it in. Grizzlick is on it. Chased by Paquette, back of the net. Cedric Paquette collides with Marchand. Brad Marchand up with the puck, and he takes off with it down the wing. Tries to get around Petrie. Marchand left it. Bergeron with a high shot right on, and Montembeault will hold on.
Montembeau's been excellent, and at the other end, Ullmark not tested a lot. Although in the second period, a little more work, and Suzuki, who's been all around it all game long, goes wide and finds Lekkonen right in front of the net. And again, Ullmark, I think, got across just enough to get a piece of it with a little help from his defenseman.
Lekkonen, by the way, just the second Finnish-born defenseman to score a goal in a Bruins uniform in franchise history. Jarno Kultinen was the other one. There's McAvoy. Made it across, and that shot was wide as Coyle was trying to cause a little traffic in front. Now Caulfield up with it. Got it off the glass and out. Riley will settle it down. Played it off for McAvoy. Jeff Petrie. Pass off the boards. Up ahead for Dauphin. Hits it into the corner. Bailing. Back around to the point. Here's Nyku. Throws it towards the net. Tipped and goes wide. Eric Holla can't clear it out. Wyman kept it in. Throwing it front, chance for Nyku, and that one just goes wide as well. Ullmark might have got a piece of it. Nyku with it, throws it towards it in with Dauphin getting caught up in the traffic in front. And then Ullmark reaches out and gave a little pop to Dauphin. Now Dauphin is grabbed by Holla. He swings at him, and we're going to get everybody piling here again as Dauphin tried to get some shots back on Holla with him down. And what do you know? It's the Bruins and Canadians. And tempers are flaring.
And Ullmark's going to get the extra two here for sure for interference. And he was upset with Dauphin earlier, getting him into his kitchen here. There's not the penalty there. And there's an extra shot, extra shot. Here comes the penalty right there.
Oh, heated tempers for the Bruins and Canadians.
He really got his Boston Bruin team on a roll with a couple of goals. One batted out of the air, and then he goes to the net for the shorthander to get the hat trick.
And that hat is a beautiful thing right there.
Maybe they'd cover up that mess that he has on his nose at the moment when he wears it after the game. Poor guy, he got that the last game against the Capitals we showed you earlier in the show, and then he just jumped right out afterwards the next shift and got an assist and a goal. And boy, they are wound up in Boston tonight. I don't know what's going on, but this crowd has been very vocal. Maybe it's the Montreal Canadiens that brings the best out of them, but a full house, and they're enjoying this.
Well, Boston has earned at least a point in 13 of their last 15 games against Montreal, dating back to December 12, 2016. 12-2-1 on their way to making that 13-2-1 tonight. Lekkonen drops it off for Brandon Carlo up the boards and out. And it's lifted right back in. Carlo knocked it down with a high stick, and that'll bring a whistle.
You know, my 29 years of broadcasting now, I don't think that I've ever shown anybody's legs before. So this is the first, just when you think you've seen it all. But they're making quite a big deal out of Steen, Oscar Steen's quads. And he's not a very big man, but his center of gravity is low, and he's powerful. And they equate that to Martin Saint-Louis, who was built in a very similar fashion. There's a first for everything, Bartz. There you go.
Yep.
The way these guys train today, though, on their quads in that area, like, it's crazy. The lifts they do. A full-time job, year-round, for all of these athletes in today's game.
Pezzetta got it off, down for Dvorak in front for Drouin. Couldn't get the shot through. Bruins lift it up on the wing. Nyku trying to hold it. It comes out. Pezzetta's there.
Minor penalty interference.
There's Drouin. He'll tip it in. Pezzetta, bumped by Vaccanato, tried to throw it in front, and Craig Smith cut it off, and here comes Smith. Up to center, down the wing. Smith throws it back to the net. Patrice Bergeron goes after it. Hit by Petrie. Suzuki will work the puck out. Puck dumped in from center. Here's a chance for Marchand. Snapped it on net. Club by Montemone and played off for Petrie.
And as expected, Boston has managed this third period with the lead. Good habits, as you could tell. They're loading up the neutral zone, only taking chances when the offensive opportunity presents itself.
Jeff Petrie trying to move it up through center. Puckett will lift it in. Riley is there around the boards, and it's picked up by Oscar Steen. Cut off at center. Here's Coyle. Dumping it back in. Out of the net is Montembeau. He'll play it off the glass. Paquette there waiting for it. Tipped it off for Vedemo. Lucas Vedemo. Looks to the front of the net. Tried to connect with Armia. Steen bumped by Armia. Hooked around for Riley. There's Cole Caulfield jumping on a loose puck. Snaps it towards the net. And it's high and wide and ends up out of play.
Well, Bruce Cassidy looks like a genius after Christmas, switching Pasternak and Smith on those two first lines for the Boston Bruins. And both the Bergeron line and the Hall line have been red hot since he's done it. And they've been hot again tonight with a bunch of points between them. Hall now with Hall seems to give them a little more speed in that second line with Pasternak, the shooter. And Smith just grinds it out as he always does with Bergeron and Marchand.
Here's Sherratt with it. And Sherratt got it through center, tipped in. Grizzly going after it. And Grizzly will get it up ahead onto the wing. A nifty little move there as Montembeau's forced to play the puck with Anton Gleed trying to jump around his man. Caulfield will hand it off for Poehling. Fired on net. Stopped by Allmark and grabbed by Nosa. Widener trying to catch up to Iniku there, and it is deflected into the Bruins bench.
Well, I mentioned that Suzuki's been a bright spot for Montreal all game long. Pezzetta, you know, he's just trying to stay in the league, and not the most skillful player in terms of a top six player, but you know something? He works hard. He's been physically involved. He's tried to be a difference maker. And you can tell that he doesn't want to ride a bus anymore in the American League the way he's been playing. And good on him for doing that.
Backing out and going after the puck. Check to the corner. Drouin's after it. There's Dvorak trying to feed it back for Weidman. Cut off by Hall. Taylor Hall will bring it in. Into the skates of Lazar. Smith. Tried to take it away from Pezzetta. Now it comes to the point where Hall will find it. Riley for Lazar with a shot off the post. Scramble for it, and it's picked up by Lazar. He'll play it back for Riley. Taylor Hall spins. His shot went off the skate of Niku. Vaakanainen around the boards. Pezzetta. Got it. Took the hit from Hall. Didn't like it. Took a swipe at him as Drouin's got it. And they'll send it back for Niku.
Well, the next story for the Boston Bruins, the fans will get their wish as Tuukka Rask will get the next start.
And that'll come tomorrow against the Philadelphia Flyers. A game you can see on Sportsnet. Puck lifted in by Armia. After it goes McAvoy. Onto the wing. Steen has got it. Left it for Coyle. Little cross at the line. A Grizzly grabbed him. That'll end up being an offside.
And for the Montreal Canadiens coming in, they were undermanned. They haven't played since January the 1st as we look at another Boston Bruin chance by Lazar. Montembeau gets a bit of a break as it hits the post. May have got a piece of it. He did. But for Montreal, they competed hard. They did the best they could under some very difficult circumstances. They're undermanned and they haven't played since January 1st. Almost an impossible task against a very good Boston Bruin and Red Hawk team.
41-25, the shots in favor of the Bruins in a 5-1 victory for Brad Marchand. It's the hat trick and a Boston win as the Bruins have won three straight.